writing's on the wall. But if your mind's neglected, stumble you might fall, stumble you might fall.
December 1994. The Criminal Justice and Public Order Act is now law. All over this disunited kingdom, people have become instant criminals. Your lifestyle is illegal. The government has declared war on you because of the way you live. Will you fight back?
My fundamental concern about this bill, besides the concerns that I have that relate to music festivals, the homeless, and also to trespass, so-called, is the far-reaching effects that will trickle through to literally every single individual. Because although they may not be concerned about it now, they will be concerned when it's their turn to be attacked. They may be attacked in different ways. They may not be a tank arriving in their street. It could be, for example, a motorway going down behind their house. It could be the closure of their local school. It could be the closure of their hospital. It could be the closure of various community facilities. It could be the closure of a pit. Now, what's happened over the last 10 years is that people have objected to that, and they've got together, and they've gone onto the land where those facilities are, and they've said, no, you're not closing this hospital, this school, this pit, or whatever. Ah, well, what this bill is aimed to do is to criminalise those people who up to now have not been criminalised, so that they will be intimidated from going onto the land because they will be breaching police directives if they do. So actually...
You are organizing a free party in a field in the country for you and some friends. You arrange for a generator sound system, lights, and DJs to play some repetitive beats. And that afternoon, go there to prepare. But the police turn up. They say, if you do not remove yourselves and your equipment, you will be arrested. You could be jailed for up to 3 months. You could have your equipment taken from you and sold. All for a little party. Do you back off? Or do you fight back?
The problem has been that the Labour leadership has tried to engage in the debate on Tory terms. They've sought to sort of out-Tory the Tories on who's going to lock people up for the longest and in what way and what punishment's going to be meted out. And whilst conceding the argument we have to look at the causes of crime, this has led them into a terrible position on the Criminal Justice Bill. The Criminal Justice Bill is an evil piece of legislation which removes the right of assembly, removes the right of silence, removes the right to roam and the right to travel. It's an attack on people's lifestyles. Labour should have voted against it on a three-line whip in the House of Commons in April. They didn't. Only 45 MPs voted against it. It comes back to the House in a couple of weeks' time. I'll do my best to continue opposing it, and this demonstration to here really is the biggest message the Labour Party could have, saying there are millions of people around this country who want to lead in the fight for justice in Britain.
You're on your way to a friend's house. The police stop you. They say they have reason to believe you might be going to an illegal rave. But the rave is over 4 miles away, and your friend lives nearby. They don't need proof. If you don't turn back, you will be arrested. Do you turn back, or do you fight back?
The Criminal Justice Bill is going to make a big difference to this country. Not only because it's turning on a new, young generation onto politics, to realising they've got to change the system, but because they are the first generation to realise that the way this country is run can affect everybody, and indeed it can turn criminals, turn not just young people, not just ravers, not just people who are different, but even ramblers, for example. There are 100, 200,000 grey-haired, middle-aged people who like to walk the country who are being turned into criminals or potential criminals by this bill. And there's going to be a huge alliance of protests. There are middle-class people who say, look, I've dealt with the police, but I want to have the right to silence. This is a right that goes back 300 years. It's a basic protection of the innocent. It's not a way of getting hold of the guilty. So this bill is going to have very, very profound implications for everybody, and that's why it's going to be defeated. Thank you.
You live in a squat. There is nowhere else for you to go. You and your two children have lived there for over a year. One day, a bailiff arrives at your door with a court order for you to leave. You have 24 hours in which to find another place to live. If you don't leave, you could be arrested, charged, and sent down for up to 6 months. Do you go back to the streets, or do you fight back?
They haven't got an economic policy, they've got a political policy to drive most people back on their knees and have the country run by a handful of their friends. That's what it's all about. And the Criminal Justice Bill is to try and blame those who are the victims of their system. And there's no truth whatever in what they say. If they spent the 75 billion quid we waste on weapons and on unemployment and on the fight against crime on giving people an opportunity in life, we'd have a much happier and more favourable society. And that's what we should be campaigning about. I'm a socialist and I think that's what socialism is all about. Capitalism is a rotten system and it is designed to hold people down and it's incompatible with democracy. And that's why the trade union and Labour leaders should have been here today.
You are a hunt saboteur. You have been arrested, charged and convicted under Section 68 of the Criminal Justice Act after the police stopped you on the way to a hunt. You have been given 3 months in jail. Under the new Act, any building or floating structure can be designated a prison. You spend your 3 months in the hold of a ship floating on the River Thames. The ship is a decommissioned Royal Naval vessel owned and run by a private security company. One of the top directors of the private security firm is an ex-conservative government minister.
The Criminal Justice Bill is not only an attack on trade unionists and trade unions, it's also an attack upon all those within society who want to raise their voice in protest when they see injustice or inequality raise its ugly head. And this bill, if it was adopted or if it's put into practice, will spell the death knell of any protest group. That is if the Tories have their way. The only way that you can deal with this bill is by defying it. And just as our forebears all those years ago had to fight for the right to walk upon England's green and pleasant land, and just as our forebears had the right and the foresight to fight for the right to belong to trade unions and to express freely and without let or hindrance their views, wherever they may be, then we too have got to carry the standard forward and defend those hard-won gains. If we don't, then we sense a betrayal of all the hard-won gains of our forebears. I think, quite frankly, the Criminal Justice Bill is not only an attack on the right to silence of an individual, it means that it's another piece of the jigsaw that the Tory government are putting into place against the British trade union and labour movement, against working people.
We're sick of seeing misery. We're sick of the fatality. Locality. Oh,
just killing the time.
You are paid a tiny wage for a hard day's work. You see company directors receiving huge increases in their salaries. You have to strike for a 3% increase. You want to go to your place of work to try to persuade your colleagues to support the strike. But while you are still over a mile away, the police stop you. If you don't turn back, they will arrest you. Will you turn back? Or will you fight back?
They want you in the military. You've gotta know your enemy. But we all know who the killer be. They act so viciously.
You know the thing of APIs is the fire fires. Is that one of the weapons we've used in industrial conflict is spontaneous action. And now we take spontaneous action, we've criminalised it. No longer can we say to our employers, that's enough, we're walking out. By doing that, we're not only going to break our contracts, but we're going to break the law now. And we'll go to jail for that. It's an absolute disgrace, this act. And we must stick together and fight it.
Christmas time. All over the country, families tuck into dinner in the warmth of their houses. But your house is in a police compound. And your family is dispersed amongst friends and relatives. You are on the streets. The owner of a piece of rough ground in the middle of nowhere has decided that two buses and a caravan, several families, and a couple of dogs are causing him a nuisance. So the police came and said, move on. But your vehicle broke down and the others wouldn't leave without you. And anyway, there was nowhere else to go. So the police arrested you and your friends and impounded your vehicles. You're angry and you want some comeback. Do you fight back?
Thanks very much, John. Brothers and sisters, there was an article in the Glasgow Evening Times on Wednesday evening, a small wee piece that was about a young woman, 29 years of age, she's a one-parent family, two kids. She's been caught shoplifting from Marks and Spencers. She's been caught stealing three pairs of pyjamas and four pairs of underwear. She was taken to court and she was given 4 months in jail. 9 months ago, 9 months ago, there was a guy called Hamilton. Some of you may remember him. He mounted the pavement 110 miles an hour. He drove through three police roadblocks. And when he eventually crashed, he assaulted a policeman. When he went to court, he got 200 hours community service. Brothers and sisters, if you're working class, and you're from the housing schemes of Britain, then you can expect the justice of the British state sending down single parents for shoplifting. But if you're from the dukes and the duchesses, then you can assault the police, you can drive through roadblocks, and you can get 200 hours community service. That's British justice.
Get no supper tonight. lot of people won't get no justice tonight. The battle is getting hard.
You are arrested for something you didn't do. You don't know your rights, so you wait till your lawyer arrives before you answer any questions. While you wait, the police ask, "Did you do it?" You say nothing. At your trial, the court takes your silence as an admission of guilt. You are sent down. Do you answer back, or do you fight back?
Well, throughout the silence, they tell you that you have nothing to fear, you're innocent. And they want to abolish the right to silence in the police station, no. This is going to make it so much easier for the police to put people in prison. I met so many people in jail. And honestly, I don't wish to be unkind to them, but they're so susceptible to being persuaded by someone who would intimidate them in a police station. And if this is allowed to go through, this criminal justice bill, all it's going to mean is more Guildford 4s, more Birmingham 6s, etc, etc. They will tell you that they brought in new safety measures, i.e. pace. But look at the record of that since it started. What happened to the rights of the Tottenham 3, the Cardiff 3, the Darvell brothers, the Taylor sisters? The list is endless and it's still going on today. No, there's only one way for to ensure your rights, and that's to keep the right of silence. This is a privilege, a right that we have. And we shouldn't allow the Tories or anyone else to take it away from us. And people must remember that a Tory party, like any other party, is elected by us, the people, for the people, not for them. And this charter, the Criminal Justice Bill, this is a charter that any dictatorship in the world would be proud of.
Do you fight back? Of course you do. You can't do anything else. The government has made you a criminal. They think they have you in checkmate. But you're not alone. There are thousands of people affected by this act. And if we all join together to fight back, then these unholy laws will be repealed. It's called the Criminal Justice and Public Order Act. But we know there is no justice. Just us.
We don't kill this bill. Yeah. This bill will end up killing us.
Yeah. Children.
And it's not just us, the older people.
Yeah.
It's you, the youth of this day, that
yes.
are aiming at. It's you that they are trying to condition
yes.
for the future so as they can control you.
Yeah.
That's what this bill is all about. Controlling the public. You're not allowed to assemble. You're not allowed to demonstrate.
Yeah.
Before long, if the Tories had their way, they would end up making us pay for the air that we breathe.
Freedom.
Thank God they can't do it. But the only thing that we have to do is all stand together. The next 12 months is going to be very, very crucial.
Freedom.
This becomes law in January. It's nothing we can do about it going through. But the one thing we can do, we can go out and demonstrate and show them that we're not going to take the land down. And if more and more of us get up and go out in the streets, we get this bill stopped.